My name is Max. I'm from Highland Park in Northeast Los Angeles. Running is really important to me. Track season is during the springtime, so then it's really close to the summer, and that's when it gets really hot. It goes from 90 to 110, 112 even sometimes. LA has a lot of concrete, and when the sun's hitting it, it absorbs a lot of that heat and makes it 10 times worse. There is this one track meet. It was just blistering hot, and while I was running, I started to feel my feet hurt really badly. Once I finished the race, my shoes were a little bit melted, and I was like, oh my gosh. After the track meet, my friend and I went to the bathroom, and as I was washing my hands, I hear a loud thud behind me, and I turn around and saw that she had fainted. And we found out that it was all because it was so hot and she wasn't hydrated enough. My friend fainting after that track meet was pretty traumatic, and my shoes melting and all of that all together, I was thinking to myself, I don't think this is normal. There is a lot of air pollution in LA, and it's really noticeable. A lot of people are like, it's just fog, but it's not fog, it's smog. And you just think to yourself, I'm in the middle of all this, and I'm breathing all of that air, and what can I do about it? Especially the summertime. The heat makes the smog more intense. They would have warnings that would say, don't go outside, stay inside. And that shouldn't be happening. People should be safe when they're walking, just walking down the street. And the fact that it's all because of the heat and because of the air pollution that's causing all of this, we need to do something about that. So when we talk about the people who are most affected from climate change and air pollution, I think about my community and my neighborhood, because a lot of the times it's those people who end up living right next to the freeways and right next to really dense areas, and they're the ones breathing this air. A lot of the times people don't see climate change as violence, but it is. When I look at my niece, I can't help but think of what the future will look like. What if she's not able to run on the street in the way that we do because it's always so hot? Or something so simple as breathing air is something that she needs to be afraid of? It's so scary. That's really scary. This is none of her fault, and she was born into this. It makes me feel like I have to do something